Hello, I'm Chris Menard. Feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Microsoft Excel for the web has a popular feature that has just been added to it that's always been in the desktop. It is text to columns. Let me show you how it works on Excel for the web, but I first need to show you how it works on the desktop because there is a slight difference that I want to make sure you're aware of. So I'm going to pull up my Excel for the desktop first. I've already got over in column A, last name, comma, space, first name. Highlight them. Text to columns is on the data tab in both desktop and web version. Text to columns. Step 1 of 3, next. How is this information separated? If you notice down below, here's my data. If I check comma, it separates it, but do you see that space in here? So you also check space to clear out that leading space right there. Then you can hit finish, and I would go and label this last name and first name. But on Excel for the web, here we go. Last name, comma, first name. I would normally only insert one column, but trust me, I need to put in two columns, highlight. And by the way, if you're not sure how many columns to put in when you do text to columns, just put in a few extra because you can always go back and delete them. Data, here we go, brand new, text to columns for the web. Here's my screen. I have nothing selected, so there's my data. If I check comma, you're saying, Chris, that is correct. I'm going to go ahead and apply and show you the problem here. When I hit apply, if I do the function equals LEN, that will return the number of characters in a text string. Chris should be 5 characters, but I end up getting 6. It is picking up a leading space in every one of these. Mark should be 4, I get 5. You can see the leading space right before the C in Chris. So I'm going to undo a few times, Control Z. I'm actually going to put in, I've got 2 columns in here, so here we go, highlight, text to columns, comma we know is correct, but watch what happens when I hit space on the web version of this. So now it's putting in an extra blank column. That is okay. I'm going to hit apply, delete this one column. So this is what's slightly different. Again, name it last name, first name. Equals LEN tab. Trust me, this will give us the number 5, which is correct. And let's make sure we get 4 for Mark and 5 for Carol. We're good. New feature. I love it because a lot of times I find myself using Excel for the web, especially when I'm sharing files with people on Teams, OneDrive, whatever. So great feature they've added, text to columns. If you have any questions or comments, let me know and feel free to subscribe. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.